What's good, YouTube? It's your girl, Miss Golden 83, and I am here to do an all my love reading for the sign of Pisces. Okay, Pisces, you guys are second this week on the zodiac lineup. Hopefully you guys are doing well. Remember, you guys, these are general messages, not personal, so take what resonates and pass the rest to the next. Okay. Just so you guys know, I am not trying to set any mood with you guys. Although if it's a vibe, it's a vibe. Okay. Your girl's power is out. So I'm still here trying to get these readings done. Okay. Right when I was getting ready to do readings, and I was just kind of like watching a little bit of football. And next thing I knew, we had some rain, some like passing rain. And ended up with a little bit of an outage. So waiting for that to come back on, but I'm gonna still get these readings in. Okay. So it's going to be a mood. It's going to be a vibe. I have my lantern over here and I have a candle over here on the side. Palo Santo to be exact. Okay. Just in case you were wondering. Now, just so you guys know, if you haven't found out already, these all my love readings are taking the place of the Tap Into Your Souls, okay? Tap Into Your Souls has been discontinued per my ancestors. We got enough out of those readings as far as energy-wise. We got enough out of those as we could. But if you are still in need of them, they are available on my channel. Just go to my playlist. Tap Into Your Souls is right there for you, okay? These all my love readings are literally just the same as the Dreamcatcher reads, okay? However, they are just slightly different as they are pertaining to love, okay? They can be love in reference to a relationship, love in reference to friendship, love of self, or love as in a profession, okay? Depends on what comes out, okay? Because there is some channel. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and shuffle this deck up. It may be hard for you guys to see the actual cards while I'm holding them up. So hopefully that won't bother you too much. Okay, so let's go ahead and cut this first one by threes so we can get started. As usual, I'm going to pull one from the top, which is for your energy, one from the bottom, which is for the energy of the situation and or person, and then one energetically from the middle, which is the energy between you and or the situation or person, okay? And I see the card that I want. There we go. Okay. So, bear with you, girl. All right. Struggling over here. While I'm enjoying my mood lighting. Okay. So, let's get started. Pisces. So, we have unity for your energy. Okay. Then we have responsibility for the situation and or person, okay? Which just came out before in the same space in the middle of your spread. And then we have satisfaction, also something that has came out in the same place, okay? So that's kind of spreading over. I feel like unity came out before as well, but I could be wrong. But nonetheless, okay? We have unity here. Okay, unity. It says you understand that the love shared with another is amplified and has a ripple effect across the universe. Okay, you understand that the love shared with another is amplified and has a ripple effect across the universe. Okay, and so I feel like that was kind of touched on this week in another card. It might have for and it might have been for you guys, Pisces, during your heart's desire read, okay? You can let me know in the comments if you watched that reading, but I believe that kind of touched base on you guys as well, okay? But you are now coming to terms with an understanding that between you and another, your love is infinite, okay? And there is strength in numbers between the two of you, okay? Kind of hearing that we all we got type vibe between you and your person, okay? And so by all means, that is understood, okay? Your love is kind of deeper than any other couple that you may know, okay? And it's one of those loves that, you know, is sacred. It's very pure. And again, the word unity feels very strong between the two of you, okay? And so I think you guys are finally understanding that's what you have with your person, and you are being very open to it and understanding of what your love really is, okay? So, and what it means between the two of you, all right? Strongly, keywords, the two of you, okay? So, the next card here for the situation and or person is responsibility, okay? Responsibility, which says, you are aware of the power of your thoughts and the amount of love you express, okay? You are aware of the power of your thoughts and the amount of love you express, okay? I feel like this goes both ways between you and your person, okay, Pisces? I feel as though your person may feel like it's either your person or you, okay? And maybe the both of you feel the same way, because I'm feeling like it's kind of the same, all right? In the sense of taking the responsibility of really letting each other know how you feel about one another, okay? Being a little bit more open, if you will, about your feelings for each other, complimenting each other throughout the day, okay? Just to kind of reignite that unity that you have between one another, okay? And so I feel like you both take that responsibility on to, you know, control your thoughts, control your feelings, and really address them to one another, okay? Something that we kind of touch base on in, I think, your ancestor read is talking to one another a little bit more, kind of doing a little check-in, if you will, to make sure everything is okay. Any problems you have with one another, you should be able to voice them calmly and maturely to one another, not yelling or arguing, things of that nature, okay? Sometimes it's fun in a joking way, but sometimes you need a little bit of softness, okay? And so just expressing your love in a softer way brings your unity that much closer and tighter where no one can break it, okay? So next we have satisfaction, which is the energy between the both you and your person and or situation, okay? Satisfaction, which says you let the energy of love guide you to self-approval so that others no longer define who you are, okay? You let the energy of love guide you to self-approval so that others no longer define who you are, okay? You both are satisfied within your relationship, okay? You do not need others to define your relationship, okay? Did you know that when people actually define your relationship or who you are as a person, even individually from your relationship, it does cause a hindrance on that said connection, okay? So if you remove that and be satisfied with where you are in your relationship, in a sense of, like we talked about in your ancestor read, not being in competition. I don't know if it might have been your heart's desire reading, okay, in regards to being in competition with others, okay? removing that and just being satisfied with where you and your person are is more important than what other people think of you. Okay, so kind of take that into consideration. I feel like you guys are already there or maybe on the way there. Okay, so we're going to go into this Island Time Wellness to see what your focus is on or should be on. Okay, so again, Pisces, I pretty much have been saying this all week. Hopefully you don't mind sharing your energy with more than one sign, okay, or anyone with your sign in their birth chart, okay, as that is possible. So I end up reading for everyone, okay, but this may just hit all sun signs in Pisces, okay. So let's see what you have. You have love call to start, okay, love call. We have a phone here with hearts coming out of it. It says someone expresses love. A message of love, thinking of you and letting you know, okay? Someone expresses love, a message of love, thinking of you and letting you know, okay? I feel like this is kind of attached to that responsibility, okay? This person truly does love you, okay? You could be miles away, just out of town, and they call you just to check in on you to make sure you're okay, all right? If it's not a call, it could be a text message possibly, with the same sentiment. Okay. Maybe you miss their call and they leave you a message. Okay. Something of, you know, words of endearment, just to let you know that they're thinking of you. Okay. And you may do, the same or vice versa. All right. That is something that cannot be broken and is very sentimental. Okay. That's what strengthens the unity between the two of you. Okay. Make sure you remember that in times of despair or when people are gossiping in your ear. Okay. So next, not going to stay in that energy. Okay. The next one is not enough. Okay. Not enough. Not enough is saying frustrated in relationship, lack of confidence, self-sabotage, fear, ego issues, and jealousy. Okay. So not enough. This person is here with an umbrella. All right. So again, this kind of falls into that satisfaction for some of you Pisces or someone with Pisces in their chart. Okay. Feeling like they may not be enough. Okay. Self-sabotage is something that really is kind of screaming out to me. And sometimes a little bit of fear or ego issues. Okay. Or lack of confidence, if you will. Okay. Feeling like you may not be enough for someone. Okay. Again, that plays into listening to others judge you. Okay. For how you are in a particular relationship or just as an individual. Okay. That can play on your emotions and can possibly deter you from being in this unity energy towards a person that you are considering being with, okay? So you have to dig in deep within yourself and be responsible for the loving energy that you give to yourself, okay? And not let others define who you are, okay? You know who you are in a relationship. You know who you are with this particular person, okay? You do not need others to define that, okay? You need to, you know, again, be humble, okay? And not conceited. Confidence is definitely a plus in most relationships, especially if you are moving forward towards someone. However, cockiness and conceitedness, no, not so much. You need to have a good balance, okay? So if you do struggle with that, at least work on that, okay? But again, do not let others define who you are just based on your past. And that could be something that a lot of people are doing to you guys, as far as Pisces placements. I'm not talking to the sun Pisces because I think y'all are quick to tell somebody where to go. y'all are quick to tell somebody where to go. So, this is for those placement signs that have Pisces in their chart, okay? Is basically to not let people define you based on your past, because I think that's what they are primarily doing when they are judging you or giving you that false sense of hope, okay? You need to realize where you have come from since your past, okay? And realize that you have grown. And primarily, if you're definitely in a relationship, you should let your person be the one to define who you are based on their experience of you. Okay? So, that being said, let's move on to your romance angels to see what the outcome of the energy is. Okay? So, I believe y'all got this in your heart's desire reading. Okay, let go of control issues. Okay, let go of control issues. Okay, it says allow the situation to unfold naturally. Okay, allow this situation to unfold naturally. Okay, and so with control issues, you may not be trying to physically control someone, but you may be trying to physically control the outcome of a situation. Okay. Such as giving space or giving time or manipulating a situation. Again, Pisces, we've talked about this. This is a trait that y'all sometimes have, is manipulating things to move in a particular way, okay? And so allow things to unfold naturally, okay? For those of you who are not in a relationship, okay? Do not try to force, do not try to push, do not try to pull, okay? Let things happen as they may, okay? There's no need to control a situation, all right? Just let it play out as it needs to, okay? Next, children, okay? Next is children, all right? It says your love life is being affected by children, okay? Your love life is being affected by children. Children have came up before. I cannot remember. I think it might have been in Scorpio's read. So you could have Scorpio in your chart, okay? Or it could be Scorpio placement. You know, doesn't have to be, just an honorable mention, okay? From what I can recall. And so children playing a part may just be a sign of which. I think possibly during y'all's reading this week, children did kind of come up in a sense of empty nesters, or you know, trying to maybe enjoy your love life a little bit, but you do have children, so it does make it hard, okay? Depending on how old your children are, I'm sure they're aware of you know of your love and everything. So if you know have children that are old enough, maybe it's time for a weekend away or something like that, just to kind of take a break from the kids. If you can possibly you know have them stay with a grandparent, or if they have friends that you actually trust them to be around, that are not a bad influence, of course, then by all means, you know, see if they can have a weekend with them or something, to where you guys can kind of be alone, okay? That's, you know, my only suggestion to y'all, okay? If that is the issue, all right, at hand. So, nonetheless, the only other thing I would also say with children, like, be mindful of how much arguing that you're doing as well, around them, okay? Because that does kind of play on their emotions a little bit, and that learned behavior, okay, can kind of stay with them as they grow older and they embark on relationships of their own as well. So they may consider it as normal when it shouldn't be, okay, if you're doing a lot of arguing, all right? So I think that's it. All right. So, with that being said, Pisces, that's all that I have for you guys this evening. I will not see you guys until the first week of October. Well, not first week. You guys are in the third week, okay? But I won't be back doing readings until then. As you guys know, I do 3 weeks and then I am out, okay, for the rest of the month. So, I have the rest of September off. But this is your permanent spot. Okay, no spiting, okay? Pisces, if you are, okay. But this is your permanent spot, okay? Every third week of the month, okay? So I will see y'all in October, week 3, okay? Peace.